Shalom. So, I got, man, listen, man. Alright, I was just sitting right. I was going up over the book of Joshua, right? You know what I'm saying? Just going through this video, it had a little good breakdown, and I was just getting my notes and whatnot. So, boom, I stumbled. No, I'm gonna go to the parable. So I'm gonna let you know how Abba move, how he moving. We ain't worrying about no motion or no other. We talking about the source himself. I'm gonna let you know how Abba move, man. So boom, let me get to it, bro. I'm finna go to the scroll real quick. All right, we gonna go to Book of Joshua, chapter 80. Watch this, and it states. 80:1, chapter 80:1, and at the end of 2 years, the Lord again sent Moses to Pharaoh to bring forth the children of Israel and to send them out of the land of Egypt. And Moses went and came to the house of Pharaoh, and he spake to him, the words of the Lord who had sent him. But Pharaoh would not hearken to the voice of the Lord, and God roused his might in Egypt and upon Pharaoh and his subjects. Okay, the God of Israel smote Pharaoh and his people with a very great and sore plagues. With very great and sore plagues, right? So the Lord Yahweh, the God of Israel, sent by the hand of Aaron and turned all the waters of Egypt into blood, and with all their streams and rivers. When Egyptian came to drink and draw water, he looked into his pitcher, and behold, the water was turned into blood. And when he came to drink from his cup, the water in the cup became blood. Stop. Now look at this. I'm gonna show you how Abba get down to let you know. To let you know how real it get. So look, mind you, I got a bottle. I got some pineapples in it, right? So I decided to put some water in it, right? This how Abba move, man. I decided to put some water in it, right? So I put my little water in the wool, right? Put my little water in it. Drunk it. You know. I had a little honey, a little bit, but it was moving so slow, so I ain't even put the honey in there, right? So I drunk the water to like half. Then I had like, mind you, I'm in trade school, so in the morning, you got a choice whether you want apple juice, orange juice, or you want a cranberry juice cocktail. You know, the little small ones from, you know, concentrate. So tell me why I pulled that out of my little bag one night and pour half of that in there. I get to this scroll. I get to one of the lost books. Cause mind you, I'm on the concept of Joseph right now. I mean, not Joseph, but well, we can say Joseph too. Cause Joseph, Moses, and Joshua all in the same WAP. So we can say both. But I was on the concept of Joshua, right? Dealing with the trans Jordan, you know, when they was crossing, you know what I'm saying, when they was crossing Jordan or whatnot. So boom, I pull, you know what I'm saying, half for the little cranberry juice in there, and I got to this scripture, right? This shows you how I will get down, man. And then after that, I just paused. I got to looking around. I started, you know how, well, you can tell another presence is around you. Like you get to seeing little manifestations, like boom, boom, like, and it be like little flicks, and then you can see it's moving sensation. It be like a moving sensation, but I'm watching it the whole time. I tell y'all, I'ma get down, man, bruh. reason why, bro. He sending them plagues, bro. Stop playing, bro, with the album, man. He the one for a reason. You know what I'm saying? He the one for a reason, man. Everybody who trying to play him, trying to be the creator, bro. You need to stop, man, because he's sending them plagues. And that was a little parable right there that let you know. You know what I'm saying? Me just breaking that down. Look, I'm going to read it again. It said, I'm going to go from 3 to 4. I'm going to read it again. It said, and when the Lord, Yahweh, the God of Israel, sent by the hand of Aaron and turned all the waters of Egypt into blood with all their streams and rivers, and when an Egyptian came to drink and draw water, he looked into his pitcher, and behold, the water was turned into blood. When he came to drink from his cup, the water in the cup became blood. Come on, man. You can't tell me all the source and his hand ain't in the earth. Just by me doing that little simple action right there. You can't tell me his hand ain't in the earth, bro. You can't. You know what I'm saying? You can't, bro. That let you know, nigga, Israel finna gather his people. He finna send his people. Bro, tell you. You know what I'm saying? All this oppression, all these psychological locks, and I'm telling you, bro. I'm telling you, Abba ain't finna play, bro. He ain't finna play. The fact that I go get some water, put it in my cup one night, you know what I'm saying, with my little fruit, whatever. And I drink half of it, and then I pour the little cranberry juice in it. And I mind you what it said now. Mind you what it said. It's no getting around it, bro. Like, it said, and the Lord, Yahweh God of Israel, sent by the hand of Aaron, and turned all the waters of Egypt into blood, and all the streams and rivers. Look. And then he said, and when an Egyptian came to drink and draw water, he looked into his pitcher, cup, pitcher, whatever. You know what I'm saying? I was just using, he just worded his pitcher. And behold, all the water was turned into blood. And when he came to drink from his cup, the water in the cup became blood. Come on, man. Now you got to understand, this is modern. This already happened. So now when it happened, it's just going to be like little parables. Certain little acts, little battle acts. Nigga, you gonna carry it out. It's gonna be something simple. Some people ain't even gonna catch on. It's gonna happen to where you ain't even gonna catch on. So a lot of people ain't even gonna catch on. Like if they ain't into like just reading his word or like just searching certain things or getting in them lost books and reading in the lost, bro, you ain't even gonna know unless you just got the spirit on you, and then you be like, dang, bro, I'm telling you. Nigga, the fact that I just did that, and then you understand the cranberry juice red. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's different color, it's different other colors, whatever. But the cranberry juice is red, bro. Mind you, I wasn't even thinking about using that at first. I ain't thinking about using that until, because I wasn't gonna do nothing but the honey in my water, right? I wasn't gonna do nothing but use the honey for my water and you know, drink with the pineapples. With filter water. But I forget I had this cranberry juice in my bag. So I'm like, dang, that surprised me. So I'm like, okay, I get that and pull that up. I'm like, man, all right, let me get back to these scrolls. Cause mind you, like I said, I'm on Joshua. I'm like, I'm finna get into the lost books as well as being a source while he breaking this down. And I'm going to be getting my, you know what I'm saying? So I'm doing this. I get the, I drink half of the water out of the bottle and pour almost the rest of the cranberry juice in the bottle. You know what I'm saying? And it's, mind you, it's still water in the pitcher. I pictured the bottle. Man, I ain't playing, y'all better stop with all these psychological locks and all this, you know what I'm saying? Tell you, I ain't playing, bro.
Y'all think he playing?
My ox say, Mark the Rock say, he said, the nation throwing stones at the throne. Don't know what's going on. Y'all better, nigga. Boy, better stop. For real. What'd he say after that? And when a woman knitted her dough, I'm going to read the whole thing. And when a woman knitted her dough and cooked her victuals, their appearance was turned to that of blood. When she cooking dough, and she cooking up whatever she cooking up with this dough, and the appearance of it turning to blood, man, that's awful work, man. And look, and the Lord sent again and caused all the waters to bring forth frogs, and all the frogs came into the house of the Egyptians. And look, I'm gonna get this. How I know Abba in the mix. This how I know boys better stop playing out here, cause Abba in the mix for real. This how I know. I mind you, I'm in trade school. You know what I'm saying? We got dorms. If you stay, you either residential or you at home. I'm residential, so I stay on dorm. Boom. I ain't use my dormitory. Shower. I'm in the vacant. I'm in there by myself. That's how I be taking myself. I'm in there by myself. Boom. So tell, mind you, know what I'm saying, I can get out the shower and look. Now mind you, it's nothing in there dirty. Ain't nobody sleeping in that room. It's a vacant room. Nobody in that room. Nobody is, you know, occupying that room. So mind you, I'm, you know, get out the shower. I'm bumping my music. Whatnot. In the mirror, just bump my music, put, you know, oil in. So I look big, I'm talking about big fat, I want to say water bug or just a cockroach, because, you know, they both the same thing, but it's just the size that make people be like, oh, this a water bug. But either way, man, I seen that mud, I'm like, bro, I've been in this room. I showered in the room before. I don't leave no water, I don't leave nothing to where it can attract anything. So I'm like, bro, this mud just came out of nowhere. I'm like, then I got to just talking about certain curses. It just made me think like, dang, bro, hold on. Cause like certain things, when you bear certain things and you know certain things, when you learned it, and then you see it, what be going on in the world, it's like, bro, I'm like, I'ma go and get into it. Okay, boom. I see it, I'm like, man, bro. Cause, you know, it's a lot of idol worship going on. It's a lot of idols going on. So mind you, soon I see the bug, I get the scores, boom, familiar spirit, boom. Nigga, it was, you know how it was a song, right? Everybody know. Cause everybody done bump pop before. But look, I get the scores, boom. Soon I see the bug, that's how I know what it was. But then when I read this, it made me, you know what I'm saying, reiterate. So boom, I get the scores. It's like boom, and you know how Pac was there. You and one of the songs, he was like, you effing bugs, you effing roaches, you still talking. I'm like, dude, bro, all this pagan work, I'm among myself, cause it made me think about the certain curses and certain why certain stuff be going on. So I'm like, bro, I'm among myself, just talking like, dang, ooh. So then I get to reading this, and then he got to tell me about bringing lights. Then, dude, it was a dude came my room. Like, it's a dude came my room. Now, mind you, he a pill face. So, he scratching his head. He like, man, I need to wash my hair. No lie. This how you know I'll be in the mix. No lie. This is how you know I'll be in the mix. He come in there. Because, matter of fact, he let me use his headphones. So, I'm like, should I give you some popcorn or something? You know, hold him down or something, whatever. So, he come in there, boom. He coming up. Like, man, I need some shampoo, nigga. I need to wash my hair. Nigga, I gotta wash my hair. This just happened. This ain't nothing 45 minutes ago. This just happened. So, boom, he coming there. Man, I need to wash my hair, bro. That's Abba, bro. He own him. Tell you. Abba in the mix, man. You don't believe it, but I'm telling you. I mean, that's three times right there. And look, that's in the same week, man. Two of them in the same day. One. in another day of this same week. One occurrence and two occurrences in the same night. Come on, man. That's not a coincidence. It's not a coincidence. It's not a coincidence. Dude coming there, man, I need to get some shampoo to wash my hair. Ooh, ooh. Now, look, let me read this. What'd it say? I'm going to start at 9 and then go down. Notwithstanding all this anger of the Lord, Yahweh, the God of Israel, did not turn from them, and his hand was stretched out against all the Egyptians to smite them with every heavy plague. Now watch this, boom. And he sent and smote their dust to lice, and get real for real, man, we back with it, but look, this 10. And he sent and smote their dust to lice, and the lice became in Egypt to the height of 2 cubits upon the earth. And the lice were also very numerous in the flesh of man and beast, and all the inhabitants of Egypt. Also upon the king and queen of the Lord sent the lice, and it grieved Egypt exceedingly on account of the lice. Notwithstanding the anger of the Lord, Yahweh did not turn away, and his hand was still stretched out over Egypt. Nigga, stop playing with the album, man. Everybody around here, they just running around senseless doing what they doing. And want to know why? Abba putting it on man, bro. It states right in the same category where Abba putting it on man. The plague is so hard. Well, he's sending them, when he send his pestilence, you got men just running around doing that, bro. Anger. They got anger. They screaming. Or I'm telling you, bro. We gonna get it, bro. And the Lord Yahweh sent all kinds of beasts of the field into Egypt, and they came and destroyed all Egypt, man, beast, and trees, and all things that were in Egypt. Look, and the Lord sent fiery serpents, scorpions, mice, weasels, toads, together with other creeping in dust. Look, now watch this. Flies, hornets, fleas, bugs, gnats, each swarm, according to its kind. Now look, all reptiles and winged animals according to their kinds came to Egypt and greeted the Egyptians exceedingly. Look, the fleas and flies came into the eyes and the ears of the Egyptians, right? Look at this. And the horn came upon them and drove them away, and they removed it from their inner rooms, and they removed from it into their inner rooms, and it pursued them. Look, now look at this. Watch this. Look. So look. This 19, this 80, chapter 80 and 19, watch. And when the Egyptians hid themselves on the count of the swarm of animals, so like they locked their doors after them, and the God of Israel ordered this this is a sea creature, bro. He sent the sea creature. In the mud, because you gotta understand, his parables in the Bible where he states his creation as the sea. And it's on another account, he states us as grass. You know what I'm saying? So look, he said the God of Israel ordered the Sulanut, which was in the sea, and came up and go into Egypt. And look, and she had long arms, 10 cubits in length, of the cubit of a man. Look, she went up on the roofs. She went up on the roofs and uncovered the raftering and the flooring, and cut them. Look, and cut them, and stretched forth her arm into the house, and removed a lock in a bolt, and opened the houses of Egypt. See, they were trying to hide from it, bro. You know what I'm saying? We be doing certain battle acts, and it be because the spirit will be on you. Like, people be in the spirit and don't know they be in the spirit, bro. Or when Abba come through, you gonna get right. You gonna be doing stuff right in the quarterly. You can be doing wicked, be doing all this wicked stuff. Soon I will put his hand in the mix. Oh, nigga, you good. You moving, bro. I'm telling you, bro. Telling you. Look. And he said, after came the swarm of the, after the swarm of the animals into the house of Egypt, and the swarm of animals destroyed the Egyptians and it grieved them exceedingly. Notwithstanding, this is the anger of the Lord, Yahweh, the God of Israel, did not turn away from the Egyptians, and his hand was still yet stretched out forth against them. Now look, this is what I'm saying. Look, watch this. The God of Israel sent the pestilence, and the pestilence pervaded, meaning it spread it all through Egypt, and the horses and asses, which is donkeys, and asses and the camels and the herds of oxen and sheep and in man. Now, last thing he said, and in man. It said, the God of Israel sent pestilence, and the pestilence pervaded Egypt. It went through all their cattle, their herds, you know what I'm saying, of livestock, and through man. So that means this pestilence went through man as well. So look, and when the Egyptians rose up early in the morning to take their cattle, boy, it was dead. You trying to pass through your cattle and it's dead. Boom. So look. And they remained of the cattle of the Egyptians only 1 in 10. And the cattle belonged to Israel. And okay, so he slew the Egyptian cattle and the cattle that belonged to Israel and Joshin. Ain't nothing touched their cattle. Look. Okay, he was sending burning inflammation in the flesh of the Egyptians, which burst their skin, and it became severe itch in all the Egyptians from the soles of their feet to the crowns of their head, right? And see that's another one when dude was like, man, I need to wash my hair, but that's another thing. He itching, he sent that severe itch. Then that lice, see, that's 2 plagues in 1. He sending them. Who gonna send them back? Who sending plagues? Who gonna send them back? Nobody. Look, what Hezekiah say? He sending plagues. Who gonna send them? Man, let me bunk my heart, man. Stop playing, bro. Come on, man. He sending plagues. Who gonna send them back? Hold back your wind so you're elect. We need to repent. Go watch the news. All of the prophecies coming true. He sent his son to die for you. Follow the steps you make it through. Look, yo, come on. Let's get there, man. Let's get that.
Good evening. I'm Kristen Welker in for Lester.
Let's get that, man. Throughout to the album.
Has now been found in 2 U.S. states, Colorado and now California.
Rock to the album. Rock to the album. Rock to the album.
This as health officials vow to pick up the pace of the vaccine.
Shadayawa.
Need to repent, go watch the news. All the prophets coming true. He sent his son to die for you. Follow his steps, you make it through. Afraid the river drying up.
Afraid the river drying up.
The devil knows it's time up.
Messiah coming.
I'm fired up. Rumors of war, we at the door.
I ran. Who we seeing now? Look, who we seeing now? They get to talk about these Muslims. Ooh, who we seeing now? You know what I'm saying? They be trying to label you. You never seen me with a, you never seen the op with no Quran. They were just talking about the Holy Quran today. They try to put that on you, cause they already in prophecy. They already looking at them like, oh, nigga, these are anti. This is an Antichrist kingdom. So they trying to hit through. They trying to label you. They trying to label you. Oh, so I'm telling you, bro. They keeping tabs, man. Young folks keeping tabs, bro. They got the, we in class, right? They get to talking about the Holy Scroll and Shakespeare and all this. Come on, man. Bro, nigga, everything lining up. It ain't a coincidence. Barack had thought of to the album. Pestilence coming more. What'd he say? Earthquakes and pestilence coming more. What I just read. He just sent that pledge, man. Bro, watch. Just watch. Keep watch. You gotta hurt my people. These folks done did so much evil. Coming, they won't lead you. Look. Gonna kill that eagle. Look. They got demons. And they keep you. Huh. The love of many gon' ask cold. Gonna let you know. Your truth, my truth. Huh. His life is death, the truth. Huh. No vaccine gonna mean some sacrifice. Huh? Would you know? What? I'ma clarify that lyric up right there. When he said no vaccine gonna mean some sacrifice. Dude, it's gonna be people telling you, man, go, bro, get the, cause they already done got it. Something, bro, I know people who was getting paid to get it. Nigga, I got peers, nigga, I went to school with, nigga, I grew up with, nigga, all type of things, nigga, and they was getting paid to get it. Literally, nigga. I had a childhood homeboy who worked at a boot factory, bro. He worked at a boot factory. It was called, I think, what was it called? It was Bell something. Not Bell, but like Bell, like B-E-L-L-E. It was something. Man, dude, he was working, I don't know if it was there or it was a farm or something. No, it was a farm. This down here in the country, it's in the country. He was working at a farm in a place called Monticello, Arkansas. He was working there, and dude, I'm seeing, you know, we out. I'm seeing him and his baby mama. They walk into the store. They walk into the marketplace. And I meet him. Cause he's staying the bricks. He's staying the PJ. He's staying the projects, right? So boom. And then we got the time. We got on. I forget how the conversation started, but we got on the conversation about it. We just talking about it. And then, cause you know, the media gon', you know, sometimes it press out everything, sometimes it don't. So you gotta have discernment to know. So we get on the, what you call it, boom. So he like, man, they was giving out money, woo woo. They was giving out this much money, you know what I'm saying, to get it. They was giving out. I'm like, bro. And then I had to, based on me knowing the facts about what's in the vaccine, I'm like, bro. Hey, man, bro, you know what's in that shit? Like, I'm telling you, know what's in that? Like, woo woo. And nigga, that, so they let me know. It's gonna be people behind the scenes. They already been to got it, and they already, you know what I'm saying, going through the motions, whatever. And guess what? They gonna, oh man, they gonna encourage somebody to get it. They gonna be thinking, oh, it's a good thing. You ain't having nobody sick. And they gonna tell you, put on your mask. That's another form of muzzle. When they tell you, put on the mask. Cause it be 1 minute, we walk around freely. We walk around good. Not freely, cause nigga, you know how this country is. But we walk around, we don't need to wear a mask, we ain't gotta wear one. Then out of nowhere, it'll be out of nowhere. Soon when, and it almost seemed like when a certain amount of people waking up and they knowing what's going on, that's when they all put on y'all masks. We finna pass the legislature, we finna pass the law or something. Now we gotta bring back masks. Like, bro, that's another form of muzzle. They trying to muzzle us, bro. Nose and mouth. Right? Tell you, some people, that's going to be a form of sacrifice to certain people. Because they know what you're going to deal with once you get it. So look, boom. Let's get into it, man. Leave out the light. Huh. These plagues are coming to the earth. Huh, look. America about to get hurt. Not people steady saying, oh, you finna. People be thinking one person or certain people they single out gonna be hurt. No, nigga, the whole North America gonna be hurt, nigga. Babylon, nigga, the daughter of Babylon, nigga. The whore. Not one person and who got this influential. No, bro, authority. No, we talking about Babylon itself, nigga. That city in the center, nigga. We talking about the whole thing. The whole thing. And guess what? The birth pain's starting to grow already. It already starting to grow, nigga. I'm telling you. Man, better stop playing with Abba and I'm telling you. He's sending them now. You know what I'm saying? That dark grossness, that gross darkness, so like, I'm telling you, stop playing, bro. I don't know why they playing. They be trying to flip the roles and be like, oh, nah, bro. A lot of people, they just be flipping roles. You know what I'm saying? They flipping roles. You ain't picking those, and then they be like, who you with? They'll flip roles. They'll be on this side, and they'll be on this side, and then they'll flip roles and be like, who you with? They'll say, who you with the whole time? You on both sides, nigga. I'm in the middle. Yo, you trying to pull me left and right. That's the only reason why it seems like I'm on both sides, because you trying to pull me left and right. Then when I stay in the middle, you try to confuse somebody. That's what's going on. Niggas be playing both sides. And then on one side, I'm going to tell you the sides. On one side. Yeah, everything be going along good, everybody getting along good. But then when that other side, he send them contracts, and niggas be, or he send them certain treaties, and people be like, okay, oh, we finna be on this side, but we gonna act like we still over here, and then we gonna distribute all this exploitation. We gonna rob the people we with. Whole time we with these people over here. Come on, man. That's in the scriptures, bro. That's dealing with the king of the south and king of the north. That's in the scripture. That's right there in the scripture. That's right there with that. If I'm not mistaken, Ezekiel. That's in the book of Ezekiel. If it's not, it's right close to the next book, which is Isaiah. Either before or after. Come on, man. Come on, man. They playing with the album, man. Keep having visions, I'm alert. Babylon, nigga. What he say, nigga? That's head on collision. What Abba say? Your kingdom's divided. Your days are numbered. Huh? Your kingdom's divided. Your days are numbered. We got generals, nigga, after a certain ruler be, you know what I'm saying? After he start reigning, you got generals. They be trying to take over and split all the riches and everything, and you can't even stand because of some effect. Your kingdom is divided. So you think you finna get over and do this, woo-woo. But nigga, prophecy, it's gonna come to pass. It gotta come to pass. You can't override the prophecy. You can't come override the Holy Scrolls, bro. Not no Quran, not no Buddha, not no Buddhism, not no Zeus, not none of them. You can't override the Holy Scrolls, bro. You know what I'm saying? Stop letting people tell you, nigga, who you worship, what you worship, or try to throw their stuff on you. So then, nigga, they can try to graph you in. Cause it been many people come to me about the so-called Holy Quran, or a Muslim, or I'm telling you, bro, they be knowing these prophecies, bro. Cause obviously everybody gonna see, even the blind gonna see. So it's like, He letting people know what's going on, right? He letting people know what's going on, bro. He sending beasts. He sending beasts to what? Everything. Man, he playing.
is in this world. Come up out of my peace. Turn my 50 and pray I see. All the singing angels cause we need. And the visions I can see yelling and screaming. A fake Messiah coming, don't let him deceive you. All them signs of lying wonders gonna be evil. Messiah open in them seals. Keep them commandments, y'all, cause his body get real.
What we seeing now? Keep them commandments, come back to the covenant. Nigga, it's getting real. What we seeing now? Telling you, bro. Stop getting AI here trying to get people to pick them sides. And whole time, he told us to keep that straight and narrow. He told us, nigga, get on that ancient, ask for the ancient paths. Huh. What you talking about picking a side for? What you asking me who I'm with? I ain't with nobody. I'm with the Abba, nigga. We don't know what's happening. We don't know what's going on, nigga. It's Abba movement. That's what he told us. That's why he told us to watch. That's why he told us to be watchful. We watching. We seeing what's going on. We seeing all this misinformation, these pagan worships. All these different pagan worships, bro. We seeing what it is. All they doing is keeping the ones that's on the straight and narrow on that ancient, who asking for the ancient power. They keeping them confused because they got to put all this, they filtering all this information out. Whole time, y'all ain't really doing nothing but fulfilling the prophecy. That's what y'all really doing. Y'all ain't doing nothing but fulfilling the prophecy, bro. Fulfilling what he already said was going to be happening. Nigga, Daniel 9 and 11, technology gonna creep, they gonna run to and fro. Nigga, they gonna run out to every doctrine. All that, bro. I know I already went to the Abba, like, bro. Like, not bro, but like, man. Allow me not to, bro, go out to no doctrine of man, bro. Let me come off from watching certain dudes who teach it. All that, like, because a lot of dudes that's coming from teaching, they'll be coming from the church. They come from the church, but they bashing the church. How can I listen to you? How can I listen to your counsel? If you bashing the church and you come from the church, you know what I'm saying? You should have way more respect for them. Not, you know, too much respect, because you don't supposed to have respect for men, but you should have some type of reference of respect for where you come from. You come from the church. I ain't never came from no church. I went to the church house a couple times, and the spirit went right with me being in there. I can never really just get jiggy with the, you know what I'm saying, unless it was my pawpaws, or because my papa had a church. So my grandma and them had their own church, so I'll probably go there. But I ain't even go there that as much. I just went there when I was young and I couldn't stay at her house by myself, and that's when I had to go. But nigga, when I got old enough, nigga, I was chilling. I was at the house while they be gone. You know what I'm saying? When I did have when I'm young and I ain't really know too much about it, I had my little fun. I played with the little instruments, the little timbre, shook the little timbre. I did all that. But nigga, I never was like, nigga, you know how many churches my mama tried to take us to? Nigga, we wasn't jiggy with it because we knew it was, no, bro. Bro, I was gonna put the spirit on you to bear witness, bro. Whether you aware or not, you ain't gonna, like, bro, we young. That's during the time of the innocence. You in your innocence, bro. You don't know what's going on, bro. You just know based on the discernment that was poured upon you. You just know based on that. The flow, nigga, the movements of the spirit, that's it. Nigga, I never, bro, that's why I'm glad I was a scratch type of baby. I was straight from the scratch. Nigga, I was the type of kid where I had, say I got two homeboys fighting, and they be like, man, and they both trying to put their opinions, or they arguing about something, and they be like, man, then this dude do the, and the other one, then this, I was the one, I even it out, I balance it out. If I'm cool with both of y'all, I ain't finna, oh man, no, bro, you did. I ain't doing all that, bro. Even though that was the case, I ain't even finna do that. I'm gonna balance it out and be like, bro, man, because you gotta be able to see both ways. You know what I'm saying? They always hollering tunnel vision. Yeah, keep tunnel vision. But, nigga, at the end of the day, we gotta get out these tunnels. We gotta get out the trenches. So nigga, we can be tunnel all day, but nigga, the mission is to get out the trench, to get out the tunnel. You know what I'm saying? Once the coast is clear, nigga, we just for to get out of the tunnel, you know, out of it. You know what I'm saying? You can't have tunnel vision forever. You gotta see both ways. You gotta be able to see every route of the field. You know what I'm saying? That's what's going on. You gotta be able to see the field, bro. And shit, as we seeing, it's a lot of, cause we now we in this Orwellian dystopian reality. I'ma keep stretching it a lot because now we getting in this. It's straight propaganda. Let me get that too. Let me go and get that so I can break it down to you. Let me get the diagram. Orwellian, dystopian, right? Dystopian realities. It's all this totalitarian, you know what I'm saying, societies. Totalitarian. I mean, reality, I'm tripping. Tell you, man, I'm finna get into it though. Reality. Alright, boom. Let's get into it, man. I'ma just go to the images. I'ma go to the images, man. So it'll give you more. You know. Cause it had a little diagram where it had it basically summed everything up. You ain't really got too much. Watch this, and you know. So we finna get into it, man. We finna get into it. Let me see. Cause it's all about. It's all about propaganda and misleading information, perception warping. That's basically what it is, perception warping. You know? Propaganda. Let me get that, man. Propaganda. Another thing, we dealing with this, we in days of Noah right now, bro. That's a, man, you better understand, bro. I'm finna read it for you. I'm finna get into it for you, bro. Look, it said, it denotes an attitude of a brutal policy of draconian control by propaganda, surveillance, disinformation, denial, truth, double think, manipulation of the past, including the unperson, a person who passed, atrocity. It's idealized from the public record and memory. And that's dealing with the subliminals. People right now, you know, in the world, they use people's statistics as subliminals. And it be as a joke. That's when you get to hearing them, oh, you telling jokes. And no, bro, you just using, you digging through something, you hacking somebody, and then you using that statistics through all the things that you know from when you hacked them, and then you using it as a subliminal against them. You know what I'm saying? Basically, you taking the thoughts. Their thoughts of their a past, and then using it as a subliminal. It be a subliminal, man. Like, come on, bro. Come on, man. Look. Come on, man. What that say? It said public record memory practice by modern repressive government was that. Ritual abuse, double speak, national security, partyism, mass surveillance, judicial punishment, permanent war economy, totalitarianism, cancel culture. What we seeing? All we see is celebrities getting canceled. Everybody who's so-called, you know what I'm saying, either speaking about the culture or living the culture or, you know what I'm saying, being creative to show what's going on in the culture, they canceling them. You know what I'm saying? I don't like to just use the main criteria, but let's look at Kanye. Let's look at Kyrie. Let's look at, you know what I'm saying? Because you got to understand, we in a propaganda type of reality. So them same people I just named can be just used as puppets. Can be just used as figures. Just like if we look at history, it was a lot of people that we referenced for the so-called Black History Month. And they was figures. They weren't nothing but figures. You know what I'm saying? Puppeteered figures. They puppeteered them around and they gave them a platform to where it was like, okay, you know, and that's what they still do the same day. They'll puppeteer you as long as you saying what they want you to say or as long as you doing or whatever the case may be. It's a puppeteer, bro. That's all it is. Tell you, man, ain't nothing new, man. It's nothing new. When it's true, they gonna discredit. When it's true, it's gonna be discredited. That's another thing. If it's true, it's gonna be discredited. Let's get back to that track, though. My art, man. My Ethiopian brother.
Lockdown's coming back. Please coming, nobody can send them back.
Look, hold back your wings to your left.
Hold back your wings to your left.
Look,
you need to repent, go watch the news. All the prophecies coming true. He sent his son to die for you. Follow his steps, you make it.
Oh, yeah, we're gonna get another one.
Excuse me. What kind of car
is like it? This is an ad.
2014 Corolla? Why?
Babylon Fallen. Let's get it.
I don't know.
We believe we are the people of God's choice. That's what we believe. We believe we're the chosen people. We don't believe Jews are the chosen people. We don't believe Jews are the ones going to the promised land. We don't think Jews are a part of God. No, Jews are nothing but another part of that same race of devil that come out of Europe. Black people are standing up. Black people are rising up. And they're so excited.
We were slaves in Egypt.
We belong
to the Father, ain't no pledge of allegiance. Both to celebrate their killing, then he didn't need you. Both to keep the holy days, don't be like the heathen. Said that for a reason.
We in Babylon.
Coming back without a warning like a
Babylon.
Think you gon' keep burning people?
We ain't having none. All praise to y'all.
You amazing, y'all. That's why I'm thinking, y'all.
So God Almighty, I got this gun in my bone like Jeremiah.
Most I keep waking up your people,
you the liar.
We keep the laws and the commandments you provide us. Then we gon' rise up. Keep a curse
on the people we ain't know.
Deuteronomy 28 and 54. Can't forget your brother, you gon' let it blow. He don't wanna raise a child,
you rather
bro. Why you think you win them trenches?
Why
you think you win them bears? Why you think you seen them dealers?
Why
you think you seen them killers?
Why you
trying to stay alive?
Why you keep that on your side?
Why you think they about to ride?
Why you
think he about to die?
Why
nobody answer why? We too busy looking fly. Turn that television off.
Need
what you put
in your eyes.
Let the Bible come alive. Y'all gon' raise your sons and daughters up.
The nigga prophesy.
Need to let go of your pride. Need to let go of your pride.
We shouldn't have any relationship with the law, not even the Ten Commandments. We should not have any relationship with the law, which is over 600 of them.
Free
me.
Do what I'm saying, though. Get rid of this image. Get rid of it
altogether.
They tell you not to keep them laws.
They don't want you to be yourself. And them laws were given to us. They ain't for nobody else. But on this guy, you a king. All the blue around the ring. Put fringes on everything. You ain't no nigga, you a king. It kept us lost for many years. We don't cry many tears. Waking up about it is. And they know about who he is. And they know about what they did. How you say you love the Bible when you killing all these kids? Y'all gon' pick out what y'all did. They knew that one day we'll arrive. Nigga, this ain't no surprise. I'ma see how coming back. Well, you gon' die before he cracks the sky. All this pain that we going through. Isaiah 14 and 1 is what he going through. He made a promise to our father that he going to. We keep these laws and these commandments that we can't lose. We waking up about to sleep, just know we can't sleep. We waking up the lost sheep, this ain't no fake news. Don't be mad at me, cause I could be the light up in the room. Don't be mad at me, cause I could mix it up and make it boom. Don't be glad for me, cause I could be the light up in the room. Don't be mad at me, cause I can mix it up and let it boom. They know America's doom. Man, somebody get the broom. Babylon right in the tomb. They got plenty of room for coon. Waking up right out to sleep. Nigga, this is prophecy. Coming back to who we are. I don't see how you don't see. Allah.
I shall keep it until the end. Give me understanding and I shall keep your law. Yea, I shall observe it with my whole heart. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the mighty.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
If you have a side gig and need to file your taxes, visit freetaxusa.com.
Yeah, man.
With us, your federal return man. Is always free. And your state return is only $14.99.
Yeah, man. I got another one.
And there's absolutely no fee if you need to include a 1099 tax.
Take a look up at the world. Tell me what you see. A whole lot of... And then me, Take a look up at the world. Tell me what you see. A whole lot of people just trusting their enemy. Look at them, man, they sleep. So you can't come and stop. You can't come inside this door unless you got a mask, you gotta leave.
Take a look up at the world, tell me what you see. A whole lot of people that trust in the enemy.
Zombies look at them sleep, they obeying the beach. You can't come up in this door without a mask, you gotta leave. Soon they gon' say the same about the vaccine.
Soon they gon' say the same about the market.
The beach. Bad dream.
Black's number one, the corona, then
stink.
I'ma save a soul.
I want a crown over my head.
If you believe in Christ, then you'll do
what he said.
Teach them about repentance, be the light they need to see. We in the last day, make sure your soul is prepared. Take a look up at this man, and they
won't ask me.
I'll be speeding up the time, and it's coming
faster. Can't get solutions from the world, they ain't got no answer.
Get solutions from the world,
they ain't got no answer. All I want is you. You the strength in my heart, you the light in the shine so true. Hold on. All I want is you. Strength in my heart, the light in the shine so true.
We really in it for salvation. Coming back, gotta be patient. Keep it commandments while we wait. I'm Marciano, gonna come and save. Love yourself and love your name. Go and reward you for your labor. We were chosen, we was favored. I'll be watching your behavior.
All I want is you.
You the strength in my heart, the light in the shine so true.
Once you do have a vaccine, how do you properly distribute it?
Just listen.
Get it out quickly.
Well, when we have the vaccine, we have the military all lined up. And
that's Revelation 9. We're
going to be doing it in a very powerful manner. These are people that don't usually do vaccines. They do soldiers and they do lots of other things that, frankly, are more difficult.
Got another one.
Our general. And
got another one.
He's all set.
Oh, I got another one. I got two more after that. I got this one, and then I got another one. We're gonna get back to it. We've been here for a while. This ain't no place for a child. Down. He say, let my people go. This ain't no place for a child. But they don't know their language. And they fill up with anger. Have you ever seen a nigga blown away? I'ma make it back home today. We killing each other our own race. We need to go back to our home place. Zion, let my people go. 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 It's a warning, come back to the Father. Back on the Father. We ain't keeping his law. That's why we fall. We not attached to the Father. Let me live in it. We ain't done the unlimited. The grin ain't feeling it. I'm swimming in it. And I'm hearing it. I'm hearing it. I be killing it. I'm a soldier for y'all. Yeah, I'm winning it. Yeah, the kingdom, I just wanna end it. Zion. Let my people go. 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 Babylonie. 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 Another one that we gonna get back to it, man. I got another one for you. I got another one for you boys. I got another one. Let me see. I got a couple of them I can give y'all, but real quick, man. But I'm going to play that, because it's about to be Passover, about probably a month and, what's today? It's the 11th month, you know what I'm saying? We got to get out there Roman and Gregorian calendar, too. It's the 11th month, right? The 11th month. So the fact that it's the 11th month and it got 29 days in this month. And it just started. It just started, man. If I'm not mistaken, it's a full moon. It's a full moon. You know what I'm saying? Just a third, and another thing, man, I gotta let y'all hear this, I'm finna just let y'all hear the tunes, man, cause I got something on the way too, man. It's gonna be called, Gots to Know, I'ma wrap him up, like my old engineer said, I'ma wrap him up, I'ma bounce him down, I'ma master him. Man, I'm going to get him right, bro. It got a Malcolm X sample on it. I threw a sample on it, all that. I want to let y'all hear the intro, but I'm going to let y'all hear this one first. I'm going to let y'all hear some tunes, and then we're going to get back to this, what you call it. We're going to let y'all get back. We're going to get back to it, man. That's how it's going to come in, right? They got to know, got to know, man, they got to know. Cause it's rough. Gotta give them the raw cause it's rough, man. That's gonna be a new merch coming out too. I'm gonna make a merch for you. Raw cause it's rough. You hear that ass slapping, man. Slugging down, man. What'd he say? You know I had to throw it in there, man. You know I had to put Denzel in that mud, man. What color was the original Hebrew? Come on, man, because we did get lighter. All of a sudden, we got lighter. Paper Genocide took over. You know what I'm saying? Paleface came with these, man, come on, man. Now, every time we go in captivity, they call us white, and we might have the blackest, what they say, the black of the berry, sweet of the juice. Come on, man.
We don't know that.
Man, they got to know, man.
Can't believe for certain that you are white. Just a moment.
I'm gonna tell you something too, man. I noticed by myself, you know, dealing with this type of thing we got going right here. This don't go off religion. This go off bloodline. It go off lineage. You know what I'm saying? Your paternal, your paternal. So look, my paternal, from what when I was informed in, we have Blackfoot Indian, right? Not, we ain't even gonna use the word Indian because that's their word. We got Blackfoot Aboriginal. We got Ethiopian Aboriginal. And then we got some more things I ain't even ran across yet, but they told me. I had just found out recently we got a little Irish, right? So just off that, that's full-blooded right there off the paternal side, right? Mother side, let's get to the maternal side. Mother side, and that side is like, it's kind of like, I don't know, like I kind of did the background on that, but I know my grandmother, she's from Grace, Mississippi, right? But I know we got Creole, like kind of mixed on that side. We got that Creole. And then we got that Cherokee. And you know when it comes to that Cherokee, nigga, they was speaking Hebrew. You know what I'm saying? When you get to, cause them ancient tribes, bro, you gotta understand them ancient tribes, bro. Cherokee and especially Blackfoot, them ancient tribes, bro. Real ancient tribes. Then when you get to the root of Hebrew itself, Ethiopia, nigga, they weren't even conquered. That was never conquered. Secondly, bro, we had some of the strongest people, not the strongest people, but we had some of the mightiest nations dealing with us when it comes to allies, and we had adversaries come against us because of our allies that we was finna form. Just imagine, okay, let me put it in perspective. Just imagine if my blood, Ethiopian, right? Ethiopia's peoples, Aboriginals. What are they with allied with Japan? It's many other people too. What if they would have allied with Japan? And they one they already not conquered. Nigga, they making their own. They independent. They basically independent. You know what I'm saying? You know, they independent. So it's like, come on, bro. Only thing now is it's modern, so now they just colonized. They got colonized, meaning that was never conquered, but when them folks start going over there and they, you know what I'm saying, they got to put their religion on them. Right? Now you might, you go over there, you might see crosses. Right? You might see a lot of crosses. That's paganism, bro. That ain't us. It ain't us, man. Then this another thing they got backwards. They call my people Ham. They call them Ham or Hamites. You know what I'm saying? And the scriptures, based on the scriptures, that's looked at as being African. Even though we in that continent, dude, you understand? It's Africans over there that never left their continent, but ain't even Africa. They Hebrews too. They just never left and went to another landmass. You know what I'm saying? Then you had us that was over there. You had us that was over there before we got sent over here. Right? And we had us over here before we had got sent to Africa. Before the Constantine Roman besiege. Right? So it's like, come on, man. Like, this is real. Where all these crosses come from? Where all the crosses come from? And why some certain allies that we had was trying to be in partnership with us, or we liked each other that much to where we finna go in partnership with them? Why? Why, man? We trying to figure out why. Right? Gotta figure out. But I'm finna let it slug again one more time.
Throughout the world are not historically correct, because history teaches us that Jesus was born in a region where the people had color.
I gotta put Denzel in there, bro.
In Revelation 1st chapter verse 14 and 15, that Jesus had hair like wool. And
wool.
The color of red. What color is that? I'm not saying anything. I'm proving to you that Jesus was not
a pale face.
I quote one of our Indian brothers, he was not a pale face.
They got to know, man, they got to know. Man, they got to know, man. But we gon', you know what I'm saying? I'ma go to this intro, cause I got this other little smooth beat. But it's just the intro. Cause I'ma drop an EP. I wanna just go on and drop an EP. You know what I'm saying? I'ma go on and drop an EP. Soon I get everything in motion. I gotta contact my old arts. You know what I'm saying? For my covers, my art covers. Gotta contact my old engineer. Get him to give me some art covers. I need to be coming up with some more ideas. I got logos. I got some new logos, but I ain't found like no new permanent logo. Cause I'm gonna keep the one I got right now. That PMP. That one sits so good to where it's like I can get a necklace. I can get a necklace and nigga, it'd be so bland. I wouldn't get it like a chain though. It'll be like beads. Feel me? Like it'll be like beads. It'll be like that trap. Cause my it's tribal. It's tribe life. It ain't. You know, it ain't no I ain't gonna keep digressing, but I'm just, you know, I gotta advertise, I gotta market, I gotta do that too. While I'm bringing out our word, while I'm bringing out what's going on in why he in the mix, man, like for real. Got to slack it, but look, let y'all hear this though.
I quote, I believe
man, that
the
beat so hard and smooth.
Black and white should live together. There's your buds. Sweet. It's me, yes, I. Gentlemen, dog. Believe that South Africa is a plural society. With contributions to be made by all segments of the community.
Yeah, man, that mud raw, man. My bad, man. My gadget. Anyone dead, so I had to put him on a charger, right? But I'm finna go and get to Hezekiah. This in my head, Passover outro. You know what I'm saying? Since Passover is almost here. Right? Then we're gonna get back into, you know what I'm saying, Joshua and the lost, you know. Gotta get into them old, you know, the lost scrolls, and you know, wrap him up. But let's get it. And it says, the Lord said, Hezekiah, Hezekiah, behold, Shaitan have desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. That's what he got as his cover. You know his name, Hezekiah, man. You know his name, Hezekiah, too. Let's get it. You ain't set apart yourself. You still dealing with what you should have dealt with. You ain't. And I know they fucked. When it hit the fan, your decision be all, but you the one who got the plan. You supposed to leave, but you fucking ran. Huh? You ain't a man. Don't run, you better not pick that ball up. Look what that lust got you. Look what that anger got you. Now all that pain inside you. You ain't shoot that nigga. You shot Christ. Matthew 20. That 45. Don't you hunt you on it. You forgave David. You ain't David, nigga. You might not wave it, nigga.
You should've pulled him to the side. But you let that anger come on like you can't hide. Lesson learned. Why you let the devil play all in your head? You were supposed to fast the demons out instead. You ain't been able to fast lately. Satan been on your line, been on that ass lately. Gave you a perfect wife, she just needed a leader.
You ain't even know yourself, so you couldn't lead her. Your brother still need that kidney. You ain't heal him yet, is you really with him? Huh? Your little brother won't even talk to you. And you don't even care, he's so awful. He asks you how you doing, you say all is well.
Knowing damn well that you gon' do it. Getting all this loving before Passover. Destruction coming fast, he about to pass over. You better have that blood when he pass over.
Pass over.
Pass over. Getting all this loving before Passover. Destruction coming fast, he about to pass over. You better have that blood when you pass over. Get it out your heart before the Passover. Getting all this loving before Passover. Destruction coming fast, he about to pass over. You better have that blood when you pass over. Pass over. Pass over. Get getting all this leaven before pesos. Destruction coming fast, he about to pass so. You better have that blood when he pass so. Get it out your heart before the pass so. Getting all this leaven before pesos. Destruction coming fast, he about to pass so. You better have that blood when he pass so. Getting all this leaven before peso. Destruction coming fast, he about to peso. You better have that blood when you peso. Get it out your heart before the peso.
I got one more.
I've got a problem that I'm pretty Lucky. Sure you can help me with. Yes, you will be paid. Did you know that there's a simple Lucky. Combination of natural ingredients that will help you poop out pounds of old rotten waste in your colon within just a...
And we gon' purge all these demons out. Purge all these demons out. We in the end time.
Huh. I see your trickery.
All praise to the Most High. Yahweh, Simma, Saya, Yasa.
Never pass aside my rock. I'ma get up when I fall like a man, like Moses did when he raised his hand.
Keeping that oil in my lap is a plan. We in the end times while you play.
I know the angels watching me.
Every day I'm really on my knees. Hit me five for offending thee. I want Messiah to remember me.
I ain't trying to hit the part for me.
Bleed the blood, watch them demons flee. Show the fire, he all I need. I ain't trying to hit the part for me. We in the spiritual war. Messiah is right at the door. We in the end time, yeah, for sure.
It's really time to something the sword.
Receive the spiritual Bible.
Like a shower. Candles lit.
He gonna destroy this in
I told Satan, get it behind me.
I'm in that secret place, he can't find me. Sending them demons at me, get around me. Open that ocean out, but he can't drown me. Who really living and walking the world? Fire is coming, what you ain't heard. Fire is coming, you about to burn. He's sending them prophets you don't wanna learn. I
wherever you go, wherever you go,
I'm
about to leave for you. Wherever you go, I will go.
Messiah, my rock, falling on commands. I'ma get up when I fall like a man, like Moses did when he raised his hands. Keeping that oil in my lap is a plan. We in the end times, why you playing? I know the angels watching me. Every day I'm really on my knees. You fall for offending thee. I want Messiah to remember me. I ain't trying to depart from me.
See the blood when you being free. Show the Father he all I need. I ain't trying to depart from me.
Invest in your future while you're investing in your country. At Columbia College, we've been serving active and reserve service members, veterans, and military families for nearly...
Google! What's up?
Hey, yo, Ren, turn that up.
Better learn how to plead the blood of your whole body. Stay in the spirit. Cause Satan could use you if you let him. You cannot win. I see you triggering. We at the end. Ain't none of that getting me. Confessing my sin. I'm watching my enemy. Scratching my head. He hit me like Kennedy. I know the devil is trying to get rid of me. Walking the spirit, so that mean I'm killing me.
Get behind me. I don't want you feeling me. Get behind me. I don't want you feeling me.
You cannot win. I see you triggering. We at the end. Ain't none of that getting me. Confessing my sin.
I'm watching my enemy.
Scratching my head. He hit me like Kennedy. I know the devil is trying to get rid of me. Walking the spirit, so that mean I'm killing me. Get behind me. I don't want you.
I don't want you feeling me.
I'm gonna die.
my pride. Boy, so lit, I'm alive. We gon' follow the Messiah. We gon' follow the Messiah. I'm a lit. A bot. Hussar. Messiah. I'm a lit. Yeah,
I'm
you can now win. I see you triggering. We at the end. Ain't none of that getting. Confessing my sin. I'm watching my enemy. Scratching my head. He hit me like Kennedy. I know the devil is trying to get rid of me. Walking the spirit, so that mean I'm killing me. Get it behind me. I don't want you feeling me. Get it behind me. I don't want you feeling me. You can now win. I see you triggering. We at the end. Ain't none of that getting. Confessing my sin. I'm watching my enemy. Scratching my head. He hit me like Kennedy. I know the devil is trying to get rid of me. Walking the spirit, so that mean I'm killing me. Get it behind me. I don't want you feeling me. Get it behind me, I don't want you feeling me.
All right, that's the last one. I want to play this one, though. This the last one, man. The Hezekiah, man. Get back to it, man. We ain't gonna be in it too long anyway, man, because, we gotta, we ain't gonna be in it too long. So, look, let's get to it. Okay, boom. We was in Orwellian, right? Let me see. Let me get a couple more sources on that. Couple more references before we just jump back into it, man. It's like, come on. Let me see, man. They gave us. Hey man, let me see. All right, so we finna give it to them. Alright, boom, boom, boom. Alright, it stated. This is a website called Insider. It stated, in 1949, a British author and essayist, George Orwell, wrote A Future Where a Global Despotic Power Control, let me move the ad out the way, controlled the people of Oceania. With surveillance and propaganda, this was 1984, right? It depicted a dark future where technology existed. I mean, this is in public realms, only as a tool for elite to control society, right? But while the book is a work of dystopian fiction, some of the technological innovations that it predicted have come true in the 70 years since it was, since it was published. Here's a look at some of the things that 1984 got right. Right, the telescreen. We're gonna get in that. It said TV, which monitors and broadcasts to the people. Right, the telescreen. It said in 1984, the telescreens, large TVs which can see into all corners of your house, are located in homes, public spaces of Oceania, right? And are used to transmute messages from the party and monitor civilian activity, right? Telescreens can identify people, notice when their facial expressions change or whether their heart or breathing gets faster. In 2019, facial recognition software is developing at an unprecedented rate, right? In China, over 500,000 members of Uyghur Muslim minority are being tracked by facial recognition cameras. Look at that, man. Chinese startups have built algorithms for the government to track these Muslim minorities with terrifying accuracy, as Business Insider's Alex Ma has previously reported, right? Facial recognition can be used to make tasks automatic, convenient, and efficient. But critics argue that there's need to be regulation, right? In May 2019, a British office worker who gets his photo was taken by facial recognition cameras as he ate his lunch sued South Wales police in a landmark case against the tech, right? Okay, the next one, the speak, right? All right. So Winston Smith, 1984, So used his speak right in his job as a copywriter in the records section of Ministry of Truth. Part of the dark ruling party, INGSOC, INGSOC, okay. It's a kind of recording device which, when spoken into, convert speech into text. All right, man, we back. So it said, one minute with it. Convert speech into text on the telescreen, right? Today there are countless apps and transition services which do the same through very few claims to do it. Contemporaneously, right? contemporaneously. As Orwell predicted, the technology useful and in demand, Android phone users can now utilize the live transcribe feature. It's designed for deaf people and can change 70 languages from speech to text in real time. Otter is another free app that transcribes speech on the go, right? Floating Fortress. Okay, focusing on a world where war is ceaseless, found in faraway lands with mysterious enemies, right? So Orwellian describes huge military bases called Floating Fortresses, right? Which guard strategic spots on the sea lanes. Aircraft carriers have certainly grown far bigger than those used in the 1940s and 1950s when Orwell was writing, but have not evolved quite to the level of Orwell's predictions. I mean, Slocky. However, Orwell writes, the fragile movement battleship has given way to almost unsinking floating fortress, creation of artificial islands. Oceanic area definitely fits Orwellian descriptions. Since 2016, China has been creating a number of artificial islands in the hotly contested South China Sea to assert its dominance and stake a claim to the route, right? Diversificator, right? The humanoid robot, artificial intelligence, lightweight android, operates a switchboard at the a computer fair and hold and hand over. It's a tool which automatically produce music and literature in line with ruling party standards without human input. Essentially, it's content created by artificial intelligence, right? Orwellian describes the music made by the diversificator. In 1984, as follows. The tune had been haunting London for weeks past. It was one of the countless similar songs published for the benefit of the Poles by a subsection music department, right? In the last 3 years, both the worlds of music and literature have announced their first autonomous creation. That's what we're dealing now in the world. In 2017, the first album ever produced by AI was released. You can listen to it here. In 1984, Orwell describes how Oceania's music propaganda were composed without any human intervention or whatever on an instrument known as a versificator. Right, March 2017, author Rose Godwin sent his laptop in a car from New York to New Orleans in homage to Jack Kerouac on the road on a laptop artificial software used. They used the camera, GPS, microphone, and clock attached to the car to record information, process it, and translate it to a novel based on its own terms, what it did, right? Crazy, huh? They said, Big Brother is watching you. That's crazy. But look, man, we're going to get back into it, though, man. Gotta get back into it. We're going to get right back into it. All right, man. We back with it, man. You know, I had to consider Dick Gregory last night, man. But look, though. So look at this, man. I don't know if everybody heard about this, but I just ran across it. It's called Digital Dark Age. And I'm pretty sure all this news gonna get to this point with the digital, the artificial intelligence, the virtual reality, and the parallel, all that. Because it's all in algorithms. When people found out about the algorithms, that's when they got to, you know what I'm saying? That's when they got to, they start using it. You know what I'm saying? They start using it, bro. So look, it said the digital dark age is a lack of historical information in the digital age as a direct result of outdated file formats, software, or hardware that becomes corrupt, scarce, or inaccessible as technology evolve and data decay, right? So future generations may find it difficult or impossible to retrieve electronic documents and multimedia because they have been recorded in an obsolete and obscure file format or on an obsolete physical media. For example, floppy disk. The name derives from a term, dark ages, in a sense that there could be a relative lack of records in the digital age, right? So as documents are transferred to digital formats and original copies are lost, an early mention of the term was at a conference of the International Federation of Library Association and Institution. The term was also mentioned in 1998 at that time Bits and Conference, which was co-sponsored by the long now Foundation of Getty Conservation Institute, right? So boom, proprietary and obsolete file formats. The problem is not limited to text documents, but applies equally to photos, videos, audio, and other kinds of electronic documents. Leading to the use. All right, we back. So it said the digital dark age also applies to the problems which arise. No. It's like one concern leading to the use of the term, that is, documents are stored on physical media which require special hardware in order to be ready, and that this hardware would not be available in a few decades from the time the document was created. The digital dark age, right, also applies to the problems which arise due to the obsolete file formats. In such a case, it is a lack of necessary software which causes problems when retrieving stored documents. This is especially problematic when proprietary formats are used, in which case it might be impossible to write appropriate software to find the file, right? Archiving the internet archive has stated that one of their goals is to prevent the digital dark age, right? So Vinton Cerf, vice president of Google, shows his concern about digital preservation in an annual meeting of the American Association for the Advancement of Science in 2015. He states, quote unquote, "As the way that we store information about ourselves develop, memories store the files that use older technologies are becoming harder to assist. That could mean the historians of the future are unable to learn about our lives." His suggested solution consists of preserving a sample of every piece of software and hardware that had ever existed so that it never become obsolete. He proposes taking an X-ray snapshot of the content, the application, and the operating system along with the description of the machine. This information should be then stored instead of in a museum and servers in the cloud, right? It's a historical examples. But I just ran across all these, bro. But I'm gonna get straight into the encryption and the data preservation, right? Encryption may exacerbate. I hope I'm saying it right, but anyways, the problem of preserving data, since decoding adds complexity, even when the relevant software is available. Historically, encrypted data is quite rare, but even the very simple means available throughout the history have provided many examples of documents that can only be read with great effort. For example, it took the capacity of a distributed computing project to break the mechanically generated code of a simple brief World War II submarine tactical message. Modern encryption is being used in many more documents and media due to publishers wanting the promised protection of DRM. What is DRM? I'm thinking it's the DRAM. They call what they call DRAM. Thinking that's what it is, but we're gonna keep moving forward, okay? Open source file formats, right? Let me get to that. It said PDF/A is an open standard based on adopt systems PDF format. It has been widely adopted by government and archives around the world, such as the United Kingdom. The open document format for office applications. Open document has been standardized by OSIS in 2005 and by OSIS in 2006. Since then, support for open document has been implemented in a large number of open source and proprietary software. Therefore, using open document is one option for archiving edible documents from office applications. More broadly, the use of open source software is a prevention measure, since the source code for reading and writing a file format is open. The code can be used as a base for future implementations. In 2007, the Chief Information Office of the UK's National Archives stated, we welcome open source software because it makes our lives better, right? Data storage standardization, right? Let me get to it. Okay. The UK's National Archives to prevent the digital dark age, right? Digital dark age. Millions of unreadable. We back with it, man. So, okay, it said criticism. The notion of the dark digital. The notion of the digital dark age has been criticized by some scholars. Some of these, such as David Anderson and John Tilbury, right? He got a weird name, but look, visit as alarmist, rhetoric. Maintaining that the notion of a dark age incorrectly states the current condition. They argue that there has been what you call it, but there has been significant progress in digital preservation, right? And evidence in the way of organizations continue to find and reuse critical long-term digital information while finding new ways of sharing these with the public. Some historians also fought proponents of the digital dark age for historical inaccuracies. These include Marilyn DeGane and Simeon Tanner's claim that the Gettysburg print revolution led Europe out of the dark ages at a period said to be marked by the loss of knowledge of the learning of the ancient Greeks, right, and the Romans. It argued that the knowledge and information about classical learning had been recovered during the Middle Ages, and it was not mainly due to the printing revolution, but instead was largely a result of the intelligent exchange between Islamic and Christian cultures, right? Alright. So then it just gave me all the okay. So yeah, man, it's a lot of ages we going into. It's a lot of ages. I can type it in now and it's gonna bring up not only one age, it's concerning certain prophecies, certain appointed time, certain parables, certain occurrences. Man, I'm finna go to it though. What is it called? Okay. I'm gonna just type in a list of ages we are entering, right? Let's see what they pop up. List of ages. And then I'm hit modernly, right? Okay, so let me see. All they pulling up right now. Okay, we still finna get into it, because I can just go straight to the list of timelines, but let me see. Oh, yeah. Okay, it said, what age are we in? I'm just go to Quora, right? I'm going to go to Quora, right? So this is what it states. This is what it stated, bro. This is what it stated, man. It said somebody named Christopher O'Donovan. He said, what age are we in? He said stone, iron, etc. These are archaeological terms. They describe the sort of stuff dig up in sites representative of that era. Bearing that in mind, I propose we live in a plastic bag age. Nigga, what? Plastic bag age, man. Okay, let me see. Somebody got something. Oh. It said, They'll likely say something along the lines of ancient proto-digital age. Let's continue reading, right? As time progresses, people will rethink which years are in which eras. After all, ancient Romans didn't consider themselves as living in antiquity. The Crusaders didn't think they said living in the Middle Age. They both thought they lived in the modern age, right? They both thought that, right? Then he said, to sum it up, people consider the present area, the present era to be modern age. However, as time goes on, we'll be grouped into different eras until we're ancient history. Okay. Damn, my bad. Slide. And everything just trying to slide off and, let me get this right real quick, y'all. Got to continue to get into it. So look.